but you would list your, remember some of the key points is listing your diagnosis separately. Always list your injury diagnosis as first, your neurological second, symptoms third, and your signs fourth. Include the severity, mild, moderate, severe, moderately severe, severe. And I talked about that extensively in the seminar on how, on the definition, those definitions based on the MA guides. And because you do have to have some context. There's all kinds of people that will say mild, moderate, or severe. Well, again, use the AMA, we use the AMA guides as the point of reference because of its high authority. And then the degree of healing. We talked about the same thing, being highly aware of acute, subacute, and chronic. And remember, when we covered these in the seminar, remember what we found is, number one, is doctors were not using these adjectives with the diagnosis. And the reason that's important, remember, is to help to establish the need for care. Remember, not just the a variable in the quantification will help establish the need for care, but a variable in the diagnosis. Say if you're going from severe to moderately severe. Well, that shows change. Or if you're going from moderately severe to moderate, you see. So as opposed to if you didn't use those at all, if you didn't use any of those modifiers, then you're not going to help. You are not going to help to support change, which is needed for to establish the need for care. So it's not just the quantification of all these variables with the test, but it's the diagnosis as well, and they all go to support the need for care. So we talk about that extensively in the seminar. So anyway. Having said that, there's all your diagnoses. Now you're listing, so there's all your diagnoses.